Bill Henshaw here again, Constitutional Kook Headquarters, and more in the way of news and recent events. Some idiot family law judge, a.k.a. Black Robe Bastard, out there in Cook County, Illinois, which is Chicago, for those of you who don't know, who just made a ruling, summary ex parte ruling, and the husband didn't even have, wasn't even on the agenda, hadn't made any complaints, nothing, summarily removing custody of a child from an unvaccinated mother. What the hell is this? Now, the U.S. Supreme Court says that, you know, you're supposed to have neutral magistrates here. Case is Tumey, T-U-M-E-Y-B, Ohio, 273 U.S. 510. And you'll learn a lot more information of this type. Send me an email, youwinincourt@gmail.com. for my information on my constitutional defense document packets. And the good news here is this was so bad even in their corrupt system that the order got reversed in 24 hours. I don't know what happened behind the scenes, but somebody, I think, got read the riot act. 24 hours later, this black robe bastard recused himself after coming to the obvious conclusion he wasn't anything remotely resembling a neutral magistrate. I mean, where do these people think they get off? And for those of you that do out there in the Black Robe Bastard Society, let me tell you, you better come up against me or anyone that I've taught what I know about this. You better not think you can rely on cases like Imbler v. Pacman or Stump v. Sparkman. BS, and I can prove every bit of it, and I know it much better than you do. You know, not only do you not have qualified immunity, you don't have any immunity at all, especially quote-unquote judicial immunity, when your ass is sitting there in a legislative tribunal and we can prove it. Bottom line here, Article 6 of the Constitution, you know, all public officials, especially black robe bastards, are sworn and bound by this Constitution and the laws enacted in pursuance thereof. Now, that's conspicuously untrue in the quote-unquote democracy that we have in place today. And on that subject, think about this. They have what they call a democratic government in Pyongyang, North Korea, too. Pretty much the same government. They're just a lot better about covering it up here than they are there. What we want to get returned is our federated Republican government of defined and limited powers. And that can happen, and with the 904 coming back in session here in a couple of weeks after what happened in the last term, you know, I'm optimistic, which is the last thing you should be with the just us system. But I think all this BS, you know, with the quote-unquote election and with Biden threatening to pack the court, you know, and especially if he's going to do it by an executive order, because if that happens, he's saying to the 904, you're not a judicial court. I can change the course of history with the stroke of a pen as commander in chief of the armed forces. And that's what may get us over the hump here. They're finally recognizing there that they haven't done their job for at least 150 years to say what the law is. And that's not accidental, any of that that's happened. You can learn a lot more about why, you know, by sending me an email, unincourt@gmail.com, information on my modestly priced document packets. It will explain a lot of stuff you never heard in the mandatory public education system. And neither did I 50 years ago. And wouldn't you know, at that time, I was right outside of Washington, D.C. What might my life have been if I had information like this at a youthful age? They want to be damn sure that none of you get it. And that's one of the reasons. But I'm here, you know, to let the cat out of the bag, so to speak. And you can learn a lot and teach your children that we can challenge the bastards, you know, teach them all the law and history of the United States they're not going to learn in school, and they can teach their children and their posterity so they have a much better chance to get out from under. You know, now if we get our nation and republic restored, that's going to resolve most of it. And I'm not going to suggest it was perfect from day one. It wasn't. But if we didn't do what we did with the compromises in the Constitution and the three-fifths count and this, that, and the other, the United States would never have existed. And we might be under overt British rule now There's a lot of us that think that we've earned a covert rule of the City of London right now. And there's a hell of an argument for that, that you'll learn more about. Send me an email, unincourt@gmail.com, and get information on my materials. But yeah, we're supposed to have the nation and republic, in theory, at least, we won the American Revolution, right? Goodness, it's not looking a whole hell of a lot like it these days, you know, especially with you Bill Gates and Elon Musk types out there. But we did, and if we have a constitution, then we have to have remedies. And in every county of every state admitted into this union, that's the most powerful issue we have. It's what I call the crown jewel of all the unopposed issues I advocate, AKA Pandora's box. When you learn about this, and I didn't get this overnight either, people, I was a slow learner. When I did, it hit me like a ton of bricks. I said, you've got to be kidding here. This is what they don't want you to know. And this is why so much of this civil rights crap goes on these days. They want to do the divide and conquer so we don't all get together on the same page and go in there after. Because you civil rights people out there, I hate to tell you, but the truth is that the 14th Amendment never existed, and all civil rights laws are intimately associated with our Section 5 of that 14th Amendment. They don't exist. They've never existed. The Supreme Court ruled it unconstitutional contemporaneously, and we're not allowed to announce the decision. That's how screwed up this is. So that said, send me an email for information, especially on the COVID packet. There's a lot going on with that now. I've got an indemnify document, and I'm going to be doing a class action, really habeas corpus with the 90 parts in Washington, D.C. on this issue. And with a lot of different questions than they normally see, there won't be any civil rights associated with it. Get some real issues there and some real answers, and I believe we can stop them. I think they've finally gone too far here. If they haven't, the only clear meaning is that the Constitution has been repealed and we have no peaceful remedies. And to John Roberts et al. On the Supreme Court, you know where most of the fault is here. You start doing your job again, that'll do more than anything to get us back on the right track and save this nation and republic, and maybe do a hell of a lot more than that. Now, that said, send me an email, unincourt@gmail.com. Subscribe, like the videos, tell your friends, get the word out. The sooner we cut all this divide and conquer crap and work together, the sooner we get these bastards off our backs. Thank you.